April 12th, so it'll probably be after then.
It'll be after April 12th?
Probably, yeah.
Oh, wow. Pretty good.
You guys, that's about a week up. That's, you guys, a week before my follow-up appointment. Hopefully, I'll... pretty cool.
Yeah, I have a lot going on now because I have that job and then I have the training part to do. There's a lot of training involved. And then after that, like, I have two classes I'm taking in the summer, so.
No, you won't have much free time to hang out as much as you.
I think I will because, like, one course is like an introductory course, it's pretty easy. So, and they're condensed, so, like, it's only from like
it's the new mothership. Nitro. Toss your remote away. There's no reason to channel flip with the Monday Nitro we have planned. This show is looking way better than last week's Thunder.
What kind of course did you say?
Enough of the preliminaries. Here we go.
Nutrition course.
Put your butts in
those
seats.
Pediatric
course,
so that's like children, adolescents, babies, you know, pediatrics.
Oh, wow. Looking after the baby, I guess.
Well, it's like a more than that. It's like it could be babies, but let's just say like a pediatric would be like age 0 all the way up to like 18.
Oh wow! So
like it's a wide range. You see, like teens are counted pediatric too.
Huh.
Pretty much anything that's not an adult.
Yeah, basically, that sounds like anything that's not an adult.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, because I want to do pediatrics, I think, so.
That's pretty cool. Yeah, I don't know.
Probably not eating.
Yeah, he told me he doesn't want to eat. pretty bad, but what can I do, right? I'm just gonna sit and make sure that all things still friends, right? Because he said it.
Yeah, but he needs to take care of himself too. Yeah. Otherwise, he'll die. It doesn't matter. And then you would just be sad. You would feel mad. Feel guilty for not, you know, you would feel guilty, right, if he died.
But what I guess a little bit, yeah.
Yeah. I think that's, you know, and his opponents. First, like, did he get from Manchester, England.
I think he is, yeah. He is being counted, but I'm not sure what he actually says he's counted.
A true powerhouse in every sense of the word. One of the most powerful superstars ever to grace a WWE ring. And a man whose bark and bite are equally
lethal. My coworker was saying to that. Made his debut when you're really
on the independent circuit of the United Kingdom in 1977, has influenced countless superstars of today.
What is it like here when you're bent on a way to how much you're supposed to Maybe that's why. Oh, that, I think that could be. I think my coworker said, depending on your weight, if you have your weight kind of factor into it.
Here comes the world's largest athlete!
Yeah,
of his career right now. I think he's on C-Sax's diet.
Huh.
That's a great thing.
Very nice. Very interesting.
You said a coil is better than 20 years and more dominant than he's been in years.
Yeah.
Just the look on the face of the Big Show says it all. I am here. I am ready.
So what are your thoughts for the rest of this?
To dominate.
Giant.
No.
There's only one.
Maybe do some schoolwork and, maybe I'm gonna make a sign. Just because I'm feeling
sad. Wait. You've been feeling sad? You've been feeling
sad? No.
maybe you guys can help each other.
Series match like it was yesterday. I was there backstage and the Big Show was a man
possessed
that night. Never underestimate the element of surprise, gentlemen, especially when that surprise is a 7-foot giant for the WWE Championship. This is what
actually
makes one of the best in the business. Somebody
not close. Complicated, I guess.
He's going for it all.
They're causing stress.
What
a strike. He wants no part of the outside. The Macho Man. That one fails to connect. Great idea by him. Too bad it was awfully executed.
What the heck? They want
to see how long he can sustain this attack.
We're
about to see a high risk move from the top rope. Boom, what impact.
I don't know. I just don't know what to do with him on the side of the family anymore.
Oh my god, what
a move! That's okay, you know, just worry about yourself.
Military press! Oh! Right to the back. Randy Savage in a tough spot here. Guys, he's gonna have to turn things around quickly if you want to. What a nasty knee lift. Roddy Piper's going for a harsh impact. He's making a statement here with this attack.
Hold on. I'm still kind of.
And what a
sometimes I'm so scared of being independent.
Fair.
I mean, I think I'm doing a little bit better. More. I mean, it's just.
And Roddy Piper slips out of harm's way.
I think you were burnt out at the beginning. You have to do all that physical work.
Just ain't gonna do it.
All the emotional stress.
It's definitely better than the last six months of last year.
Big Show looks like he's really struggling right now under the pressure.
It's about as bad as it gets for him. He has got to fight back. Oh man, he has plenty of reason to be concerned here, guys. But you know what? So does his opposition. This is about as close as it gets. When this guy's on, look out. What a strike right on the mark.
Kelly is part of my family, for sure.
Oh boy, he is rolling.
Needs some help.
Randy Savage with a nice reversal.
So it's
on the apron.
I don't know, maybe it's just me saying that. I think she does treat me as family.
And there's the reversal.
I don't know, I'm just maybe a little bit scared that
The
British Bulldog, one of the all-time greats in the WWE, loves to excite his fans. That could have been it
I don't know why mom never treated her.
There he goes.
Smashing to the floor. Treated her nicely because I don't think she did deserve that.
Yeah, when he's going like this, no telling how long he'll keep it up. Randy Macho Man Savage is one of the most intense and unpredictable competitors to ever enter the ring. Axe Hand finds the mark.
No, I know that. I know. Well, I did. I kind of figured that out because when I
was. Randy Savage finds its target.
Oh, at that time, they wanted to see what my mom had. Until I figured out it was part of her disability. That it sounded like her parents tried to hide it. Yeah. Because it seems like they don't really acknowledge it, I guess.
You know,
how can I do that? I'm just not physically here.
You gotta believe this one's over.
You definitely get the kid and then
Oh my god.
If you get that, you can get to find out if your brother is true.
I wonder. That would be kind of funny if there was a brother.
Knee is a lethal weapon.
Isn't there a website on that? An S3 or something?
The British Bulldog.
Family history. I want to always want to take a look at that, but I wonder if it costs money.
This is what makes him one of the best in the business. I would do one day, but
I kind of want to do one day just to see if I can
finish the
streak.
This one's getting ugly. You might want to turn away if you have a weak heart.
Randy Savage. Do you think I should go do it in step three, or do you think I should go through like a while? How much does it cost
to do it every time. He's stalking his opponent from the top turnbuckle. He's an expert, but it will tell you like
he's looking at it.
Very cool.
Fine.
He's bringing it back inside the ring now. Interesting decision.
That'll be interesting.
For example, for
I don't know. I kind of like it. He clearly wants to inflict some more punishment. When this guy's on,
she did it, and she had like 1% black or something.
1%
or like 5%.
Really?
And if he hits this,
yeah, very cool.
Knee lift. Somebody better check his nose.
I don't think I would have a. If she has a 12% edge, I wouldn't have high edge.
He's got the sleeper locked in. The sleeper hold is locked in. This could be it.
Boom! Yeah, I mean, I don't think Kylie has
energy.
What a slam! Lightning fast reflexes.
So I think it will. And we're all in the burn, and we're
and
all racist.
Continues.
And some people are racist, but some people probably are not a certain percentage of a nationality that they don't know of, and they're racist against that. So that
you never know, right?
They could be racist.
That's the impact.
Yeah, it's not ironic.
The world's largest athlete is on a roll. That's something an opponent does not want to see. I think it's time for the Bulldog to stop messing around and try to win this thing.
Wow.
Ring rattling!
He does think all costs are pretty funny, though. I think it's like hundreds of bucks or something like that.
Hundreds of dollars? Oh my.
$100.
Oh boy, he is
wrong. I can't remember. You don't have to.
Yeah. Oh, Mick would have given me an answer to mom.
You know what, and
there may be no coming back from this
incredible
beatdown.
Even you don't really know
what
you have, do you?
I just got told I was like Irish and Scottish and all that.
Yeah.
I don't know how much percentage of that I am. Do I have to get into something as well?
Yeah,
he's
bring
in big trouble.
Package,
the
mile,
the yeah, I guess I was going to put it in an envelope and send it through post.
Yeah, you can tape up the box. It has to be returned.
What's he got in mind? Roddy Piper's going for it.
So you just keep. So you open a box and then put it, and then after you put it in, put it back up. And it through the post office.
Wow, he escapes it. He's just got no quit in him here tonight.
Through it?
Oh my god.
No, what? I don't think I would get
the sleeper locked in. The sleeper hold is locked in. This could be it.
Yeah.
It fixed in.
That would be kind of sad to think the whole life you were
reaction from the previous match.
That you were born in truth.
Highlight for one superstar.
I guess what would be, I guess, sexuality, I guess. And then
yeah, I always enjoy watching him perform.
Yeah,
he's crazy. He is your winner, Rowdy. I don't know how that I was surprised about this. If that match is any indication of what to expect here tonight, we are in for an amazing evening. But I think we're, but I don't think we're fine enough. I'm pretty sure I'm not about to be good. We look alike. Can't believe tomorrow is finally the day that this all starts.
What?
Tomorrow is the day that my the process of the whole the surgery starts, hopefully.
Yeah.
Do you know
it's like you're gonna ever get checked?
Give it to me, Cole! It's tight in! I told Dr. MacGyver's office, and he said that they'll put a nudge to that part of you get it faster, but I was hurting. I'm supposed to get a boot email, apparently, but I was seeing an email about it.
Just think how successful
your might have been if you had once joined
Titus Worldwide. Well, there was an awful lot of trouble once.
My heart condition, yeah. If I have any condition within my heart.
Successful entrepreneur, active in the community. Byron,
you
went to the University of Florida.
Maybe.
Is it true that Titus O'Neil graduated magna cum parole? Yeah, this will be exciting to hear what the doctor has to say. He might even just say, not work again in surgery, you never know, right?
Yeah. Here's a pull. I guess that's actually a failure that he tried.
Yeah, we'll see what he says. I mean,
what do you need the nerve study for? Just because those weird foot of shape. Well, I guess it's just that my nerves, they got to see, but I'm surgery.
Oh, okay.
That's what I'm guessing, but I'm not sure. I just know that.
One thing I can tell you though, Apollo.
Well, I guess we'll find out tomorrow for sure. I'm kinda hoping I can go for the surgery. Because
yeah, it's just a long recovery time for me.
Well, I'd be willing to do it because just because I don't want to get older, maybe I don't, so it's going to factor into my, or I don't want to get arthritis at the early age.
For sure.
If
you
want to
be able to walk, like, I mean, you walk to most of your places, you can't drive, so.
And what the heck would my mate supposed to do when he get older? Is he supposed to die? I don't want to die yet. You know.
He would have died.
He
would have died.
Well, it'd just be hard to walk.
Holy, yeah, we don't want that.
Look at that man. Sanity's resident bulldozer. The enforcer,
what you doing right now?
Who will effectively remove anyone who opposes them.
What you doing on your computer?
Just an awe-inspiring sight. A massive Can you imagine walking into him in an alley?
I'd rather not actually.
That would be a bad day at the office.
I can't even play it in the video, what the hell?
Methodical dismemberment. That's what Killian Dane enjoys. No care or concern for rules or regulation.
That's weird. Maybe it's because I'm on the phone with you?
Maybe. You'll try later.
No, I just tried it on. I tried playing a video on YouTube and we're trying. So that's weird.
Oh, so cute.
Let me
love it.
Let me try again. Maybe I'll search. No, I'll search it up.
They just got nutty around here. Oh boy.
From Nashville, Tennessee. Love. At 232 pounds. Thank you. One half of the world. Okay, that works. The link that you sent me didn't work, but when I search it up, it
works. If anybody opens it, you're not going to take the delivery. You're just going to put it there, and you're going to not get it.
Oh yeah. My god.
Wait, Kenji, no, Kenji. Good boy. No, Kenji, no.
A master manipulator. Don't let the empty stare fool you. The maestro of mayhem is a master of mind games and manipulation.
You have
to be the only one comfortable that Eric Young is coming out here. Well, you should be, because he vowed to turn your happiness into havoc when he heard your commentary.
Uh-huh.
Let's be honest, don't tell him I said this, but the guy's nuts. Actually, I'd like to see what happens. This man, Eric Young, brings a whole new meaning to
I'm gonna order some rum. Well, I'm gonna have Coke. I'm gonna have rum and Coke.
And there's one thing you can count on when it comes to Eric Young.
I might have to order. I don't know. I only have like half a bottle.
And this is one of those matches where it's hard to believe we get paid for this. Well, actually, hard to believe Saxton gets paid for it.
No matter
what an opponent tries to do, they cannot penetrate the psyche of Eric Young. You can't play mind games with a madman. Personally, I'm just a little shocked that Eric Young possesses the mental capability.
I feel a little easy that I don't have two votes down. I'm not going to walk there, but I really don't want to walk the ring.
You just ask you to get disqualified. Okay. You ain't cheating, you ain't cheating. Be careful not to get disqualified. Power bomb!
Like I said, if it was cloudy or sunny, I would definitely go, but it's too green.
So agile.
The only time I would walk in this position here.
This is all part of the process, guys. He knew he would take on some offense.
Yeah, but I know he's going to make sure he keeps it to him.
There you go.
This is not where Titus O'Neil wants to be. So many variables for him to take into account here in this tornado tag match.
I know it's early, but he has to do everything in his power not to let this get out of hand.
Apollo Crews setting it up. Is he done?
Here.
Up and down, he slips out. Wow, look to me.
The bear thing struck his star.
I guess not.
Oh, arms trapped.
Have you been there?
Apollo Crews, an opponent has the rare task of preparing for devastating power moves and dizzying high flying attacks.
Suplex, making it look easy.
One through. Wow.
By Apollo Crews.
Well, I don't think they beat my liquor starter whoever it's at too wide on that.
Hits him with a gut-wrench suplex. What impact! There's so much for a superstar to search when Apollo Crews is your opponent. One of the many things that sets Crews apart from others is the opponent has to prepare to face a powerhouse and a high flyer at the same time.
What makes Apollo Crews so difficult to match up against is most superstars who have similar power.
It all doesn't have gear.
And most of the superstars who can move like Crews.
Huh? I mean, there is a rear star.
Can he do it here?
I'm gonna disorder from your beer start.
Beautiful technique.
Give some support. Yeah, but his people are hoping
he doesn't lose focus and stamina.
Young is in position. And he releases the hold.
I don't think he had it fully locked in.
Threw him out like trash.
Oh, continuing to punish them. Digging deep for a kick. I was showing my coworkers the Easter Colony special. Of insanity. They recognized the music. They recognized the music of the. But I was dancing to part one.
Shoulders on the mat.
Because it was two, because what my three. One of my friends was like, I'm a 40. He recognized it as a mixture of like songs from each decade or something. Take a look. Check so this out. I was like, I didn't know that. I had forgotten what video I was watching back then. But I don't think we didn't watch the part where you guys were in it.
Ain't nothing better than action like this.
Yeah. How do you feel about that years later?
I mean,
Jason,
you saw more Jason. And you just know the rest of the card is watching in the back, wondering how in the world they're going to fight that. Believe it or not, that's just the beginning, folks.
Jason, wasn't Jason scared of it half years later?
I don't know. I'm not sure about that.
Maybe he just was scared of himself being younger. Seeing himself young.
Maybe, I don't know. To be honest, I have no clue.
I was thinking about where Captain Morgan.
Captain Morgan.
Or.
What do I think of
that? Pardon?
Why
I'm just discerning which role I'm on.
This is awesome. Yeah, for who? Making his way to the ring from Detroit, Michigan, weighing in at 300.
With Scotty White. Bar Scotty White, lemon, gold.
Wow.
Lamb, baby. Marabou cocoa. Oh. I'm gonna try it there for a
One of the most controversial, yet one of the greatest groups of all time, led by this man. Had a unique relationship with
an apple juice, Mountain Dew, ginger ale. Oh, I can order ginger ale.
Can you imagine what the NWO would do to Byron? That's not a funny thought. Hey, Kevin's over here.
Can't leave a door. This is a real. Oh, I'm. Okay, I have to be at the door. I have to be at the door instead because of the ID.
What an intimidating presence.
Let's see what else. What else did I offer?
Oh boy!
Bourbons. Scotch. Coolers.
Two of the most intimidating forces in WWE.
Get a white claw, dude.
They have hay, y'all.
At a combined weight of 600.
White Claw? Is that good? Oh, like White Claw, Black Fury. Wow. Oh my gosh, you did Black Fury. Which one's your favorite?
Man, these guys are scary.
Well, there's lime and lime and lime.
Yeah, I like the lime one.
You like the lime?
Yeah,
I'll try. I'll put it on. I'll put that in there. Nuke.
Yeah.
ladies and gentlemen, with a huge handicap.
Given the odds here, I suspect this one will be quick and not so painless. Even though the title is not on the line, this is still an important match for the champ. He can't afford to show any weakness here. Yes.
Incredibly motivated, though. Don't expect him to be down for long.
He may very well find himself on the wrong end of this decision if he doesn't come up with something quickly.
I'm not going to go so far as to say he can't win this match, but things certainly aren't looking good for him right now. We got a cover and an easy kick out.
I'll let you know what happened.
Give it up, give me a review.
Yeah. If I get three,
some pretty lopsided handicap matches over the years, and one that stands out in my mind, well, it might just be the 2010 encounter that saw John Cena take on six members of the Nexus.
Well,
guys, here's the mat slam with some attitude.
They're low calorie.
That 6-on-1 match Byron brought up earlier. He goes for the cover. No trouble kicking out of that one.
Nah, not yet. Too early. Nailed it.
Nice hard move for you. What the heck?
Enough already.
I like munching, but then. I already spent $50 already.
Goodness, crushing it. The cover.
A lot can go wrong in a match like this, guys. In fact, I'll be surprised if we don't see a major injury occur here tonight.
Real close, too close for cover. How'd he do that?
I think it went positive. And I got the six can.
I wouldn't have been surprised if that was it. Wow.
I'll see what it's like.
To Corey's point, handicap matches are an incredibly dangerous atmosphere, and being outmanned in any way, whether it's by one, two, or even more competitors, can result in serious. Here's the cover.
All right, I'm gonna go to a checkout. Meet that door.
Oh boy, he's rolling. Oh, look, Kevin Nash is in position.
I'm gonna do 10% tip.
Harsh impact.
You must be over 19. Well, that's no issue. I'm way over 19.
There are certain superstars who are synonymous with handicap matches.
You'll be able to see my beard and armor.
A man that big shouldn't move that fast.
My facial hair and look, and then they'll be able to figure out that I'm over 19.
Crashing to the floor.
Yeah.
I couldn't agree with you more about what you were saying earlier, Michael. It seems like Big Show has been in dozens, if not hundreds, of handicap matches. And believe it or not, I'd say he won the majority of them. Yeah, but I can tell you one he didn't.
I watched my betting today.
In July of 2008, he was forced to take on MVP, Vladimir Kozlov, Shelton Benjamin, and the Great Khali.
It was, but I don't know if there's a man like it who could have turned back to this.
Felt really nice.
Your sheets are nice and warm still. My best feeling ever.
Wow, Kevin Nash is being controlled. Oh, shit breaker. What do we got here? Oh man.
Do you watch your own video, or does your mom do that for you?
He has something big planned. Oh, this could mean trouble.
Axe handle finds its target. He caught it.
Just to give her a break.
That's going to hurt. This does not look good for Rezar. And Kevin Nash, too quick that time.
There may be no escaping this fireman's carry.
I don't know. Never say never, Cole.
What? Oh, he kicked out. Unbelievable. He's still in this.
Hey, guys, remember when Shane McMahon competed against the supposed Legion of Doom in a handicap match
back
in 1999? What a joke that was. He told everybody he'd go up against Hawk and Anvil.
I didn't think I got my Craig Burke taking care of the LED imposters. I mean, the pancakes. I guess Brady's gonna figure out what this is.
I remember that Shane McMahon's handicap match you were mentioning earlier very well, Byron, and those imposters posing as Hawk and Anvil, the Legion of Doom, or none other than Pat Patterson and Gerald Briscoe.
Yeah, it was a nice chat with you, though. Yeah, I'll talk to him on Facebook. I'll give him a real mic.
Oh my goodness, crushing it!
I want like a video review. Your favorite is
true testament to grit. Wow!
Yeah.
Kevin Nash, too quick that time.
I probably didn't do sound when I was in the Ninja Chris Ranch.
What a power bomb from the
Canadian Psycho. I just let the video do the talking. Maybe the sound wasn't working at the time. Who knows? I'll check and make sure. But for this, this drink, my clock drink, I'll
He kicks out before three. Okay.
How'd he do that?
Okay. Nobody controls the pace of the match quite like this guy. He's making a statement here with this attack. Set him up for the.
Just looks nasty.
There it is, it's locked in.
Smart maneuver.
I always loved a good handicap match growing up, especially when you'd see Andre the Giant go up against two or three jabronis. Despite being outmanned, you always knew Andre would walk away with the win.
Goodness, that hurt the shoulder. Andre the Giant really was the king of the handicap match, as Corey was saying earlier. He also made quite a name for himself, competing in battle royals, as you would suspect. Seeing as he's well over 500 pounds.
I think my favorite Andre the Giant battle royal moment came at WrestleMania 2, when he last eliminated both members of the Hart Foundation to walk away with the win. There was no getting him over that top rope that night, fellas.
He's not looking like himself here.
You
looks
have
like
reached
he may have let his guard down there for a moment, and it cost him.
We've seen some pretty lopsided handicap matches over the years.
Yeah,
and one that stands out in my mind just be the 2010 encounter that saw John Cena take on six members of the Nexus.
Yeah, so actually four times a year when they get off week.
You know, I don't think anybody loves a good handicap match more.
Into the quick cover. That 6-on-1 match actually could have even been more lopsided. If you remember, it was originally supposed to be 7-on-1, but John Cena was able to take Darren Young out of the equation when he injured him the week prior.
But you know what? They should have kept taking Nexus members out, because even without Darren Young, the Nexus was able to accomplish their goal that night. Defeat John Cena. Dodges that one.
On the chance that it does.
I always loved a good handicap match growing up, especially when you'd see Andre the Giant go up against like two or three jabronis. Despite being outmanned, you always knew Andre would walk away with the win.
He can reach like 2K22.
And he got a near fall out of it.
It's hard to believe, but it looks like he still has some gas left in the tank. I've actually managed to somehow get through about 10 years left, which is tough. In like 2 or 3 years.
Andre the Giant really was the king of the handicap matches, Corey was saying earlier. And he also made quite a name for himself competing in battle royals, as you would suspect. Seeing as he's well over 500 pounds. I think my favorite Andre the Giant
moment
came at WrestleMania 2, when he last eliminated both members of the Hart Foundation to walk away with the win. There was no getting him over that top rope that night, fellas.
I don't know if eventually, like in the newer games, it actually corrected the count.
And he got a near fall out of it. Wow. I thought for sure that was it. And Kevin Nash, too quick that time. Shoulder tackle. Takes him down in a major way, too. This is dangerous right here. Right in the mouth, relentless.
How many weeks in a year, I guess. Yeah.
Incoming.
52.143 weeks in a year. But at least until he's earlier game, so I don't know what.
This is not at all where he wants to be at this point.
It's
his handicap match. It's going to be hard for him to win this handicap match if he doesn't somehow find a way to fend off some of this punishment. This is one of the more evenly matched contests we've seen in quite some time. From the looks of things, it could really go either way.
Double break. Or in case the date from the wiki like doesn't add up and you're like, hang on, I didn't understand. I'm just going to try and make it keep up with the actual WWE.
And he got a near fall out of it. Wow, Kevin Nash somehow did get it and found a way to keep fighting.
There's some superstars who are
synonymous with handicap matches. Of course, there's Andre the Giant, and more recently, Braun Strowman. But I don't think I've ever seen anybody in more handicap matches than Big Show, guys. Oh boy,
well, it wouldn't be WrestleMania without one.
Looking for a repeat.
Oh boy. How long is this going to go on?
I couldn't agree with you more about what you were saying earlier, Michael. It seems like Big Show has been in dozens, if not hundreds, of handicap matches.
Actually, believe it or not,
let's say you won the majority of them. I can tell you all you didn't win. How about on SmackDown back in July of 2020? Oh, man, Rezar took his head off.
Okay. Yeah,
he's going for the pin. A kick out. Just had him. What's it gonna take?
Oh my god.
This is what makes him one of the best in the business.
I don't really want to look at Kelly Kelly. I'm okay, thanks.
Oh, the dreaded claw.
That is the end.
Man.
I am kind of hoping to just drop the title. WrestleMania is a good place to finish your career. You drop the title to make a show of the year and go, that's it, I'm done.
When this guy's on,
it's not going to be
the game
after that.
And no luck against
Aiken there. Like the current day game. I don't know if it came out of creation. But she's not going to be in the game after that.
Beautiful technique.
For a very long time, to the very least. So,
we have seen it before.
I mean, unless they officially
love it. It's going to be a religion.
I don't know, she could be DLC for TK20 for all you know, but like, at the moment, just speaking, I'm not going to be in the game for a long time. I don't
know if she can just be in the match back in 1999.
I dropped the title of Mania, and
he told everybody he'd go up against Hawkman.
I think that'd be alright.
Instead, what we got were a couple of LED imposters.
Fucking up, down here, man, to be the sharpshooter.
Just a step quicker, it looks
like. Hey, look, it's that red headline again. So bad for the YouTubers.
This might be it. Oh my. I remember the Shane McMahon's handicap match you were mentioning earlier,
where
Byron, and those
like
imposters posing as Hawk and Animal in Legion of Doom were none other than Pat Patterson and Jerry Briscoe. Or should I call them the Stooges?
No, you shouldn't call them the Stooges. Have a little respect. We're talking about two Hall of Famers here.
Game awful voices.
Sum it up.
I mean, my commentary is not much better. You know, I can't even stay on top of it.
Here's Razor. In position for a power bomb. Oh, incredible!
A lot can go wrong in a match like this. I'll be surprised if we don't see a major injury occur here tonight.
Because I don't guarantee who the deepest champion is going to be. Kelly Kelly is tying from Natalya.
Kevin Nash reversing. Incredible.
Probably Kelly Kelly. Yeah. Or Shane. That would be pretty cool, I suppose.
He's making a statement.
Well, actually, I've seen a touch here. Admittedly, there's been some matches for titles. Just that we've had a very long opener. So, nice bang. And kind of long James Scramble match. Tag title match is kind of longish too, I want to say. I mean, we're at an hour and eight. Three matches having happened in the previous four. This one's
and Kevin Nash, too quick that time. Down he goes.
I don't know. That was you know, the average goal. Episode, University of Utah, is unedited for about an hour. I know the name.
Oh my goodness, crushing it. Going for the cover. One, two. Too close for cover. What a match.
Come on.
Looking for the exclamation point.
Is he Kelly, Kelly's going to win this. Especially because she's got the
good impact.
Although I don't know what the finisher is. Since he'll be using it, I'm just too lost to actually.
And he got a near fall out of
that might literally hurt.
I can't believe it. He just won't go away.
I'd be like, yeah, I made it to a game. The only motion I do is wrestling.
On the line.
And this over-exaggerated ass slap I've ever seen. Like there comes a chance.
Look at him. You gotta believe this one's over. He's on his heels. He's been taken to the limit here in this handicap match.
Oh.
You can see that distance?
I want to play a cool match. I want to play with up next, I think we'll do a cruiserweight title match. Probably should randomly be really high on the show. We'll do the table match. Zack Ryder versus Chavo Guerrero.
Yeah, no
kidding. She should be the biggest champion. She can
and stomping away in the corner.
She got the champion out.
Incredible drop. Reconstructing the knee there.
Oh, very slow. Just stop. And what he's going to do. And done. Okay. Not at all what I was expecting.
Double team. Bang. Right to the back.
Falling as a talent.
Now that got those shoulders on the mat. Yes! Unreal performance.
Could someone go over this mat and count how many times he's made that joke? Please.
He ain't messing around.
Three. Look at that. Kelly Kelly won the biggest championship. She lost to Alicia Fox for Raw. Just saving her energy, guys. So it was. Just saving her energy.
This was
waiting for an account at the moment. Leader's quit, by the way. She said she walked up. She's done. No more the leader. She'll be gone for 10 years or something like that.
Here are your winners, Akam and Razor, the authors
of pain. Alright, we are back at WrestleMania with a table match,
yeah,
the Cruiserweight title.
Forth in that match tells me we're looking at somebody who will someday, very soon, be competing in the main event. Plenty more action still to come here tonight, folks.
Day two of recording WrestleMania, admittedly. There's quite a few days in between the last one and this one. So I don't entirely remember everything that's happened. Today for recap.
To see if I do remember, I think we've got through four of the 11 matches so far.
I believe that we've seen Money in the Bank ladder match, followed by Jack Swagger, followed by the Hardcore Championship Scramble match, which was power team for Bad Mick Wardlow. Then we had the World Tag Team Championship 2-3 Falls match, which was a title retain for Celtic Cross. And the most recent match just before this was the US Championship 4-way Battle Royal, 6-member Battle Royal, which never existed in this game. And that saw Kelly Kelly become the US Champion. I believe that's everything. I believe I have actually managed to keep up with that. Where's one of those hated guys to come down to the Premier WrestleMania? I don't know what it is about Zack Ryder, but he just really managed to elicit a very negative response from the crowd.
Here comes the Premier Champion!
Okay, sure,
And it's Zach Wilson showing some agility.
Sunday. I don't work tomorrow, so I have an excuse to still drink. Thank you.
to something big. I really do feel like, to some extent, clinging on to the Greek Cup a little too hard, when in actuality, he could probably
six-man tag team matches exactly what we expected. There are times during a
six-man tag match where the hostility between two teams overflows. The result is complete chaos, and all six superstars duke it out inside, and many times outside the ring. It's complete and total chaos. But if you're one of the lower competitors in the ring during that time, you must return to the ring before the referee's 10 count, or risk being counted out. And lose the match for your team.
Byron, you talked about the moment in six-man tag matches when all semblance of order breaks down. Many times the two teams are so determined to tear each other apart that they don't pay attention to who the legal person is. Actually, it's not bad, just like Daddy used to do. And the instinct from both Dallas and the spin. Oof. And look at the quickness by Ryan. There he goes, crashing to the floor.
Tyler Breeze graced NXT with his presence and immediately proved in matches against Neville, Sami Zayn, Hideo Itami, and Finn Balor that the model extraordinaire wasn't just another pretty face.
Oh, nasty impact. Nobody controls the pace of the match quite like this guy. This is what makes him one of the best in the business.
Breeze's ability was put to the ultimate test at the first NXT Brooklyn Takeover event when Prince Pretty clashed with legendary Japanese competitor Jushin Thunder Liger. In the fall of 2015, Breeze and his selfie stick arrived in WWE alongside Summer Rae.
Wait, Wyatt may get this, folks. Nobody gets tremendous impact. The MMA is the boat dazzler. Now, he's got the shoulders down. Mess.
We've got to get this out of it now. Great, all is lost.
Curtis Axel was able to get out of the way there. And there's his speed.
This is not going to end well for him, Michael. Beautiful technique. He's got it down. This is it.
Let's take another look at what made that matchup so
bad. Man, you don't want to be beating anybody.
Man, this was great. I remember this part.
If that match is any indication of what to expect here tonight, we are in for an amazing evening. One last thing about this match real quick. It's amazing how fired up the St. Louis crowd was throughout the entire encounter.
It was a hell of a fight in that one. A lot of carnage. I'm hoping that people would have liked that one. I think that was probably one of the most competitive matches that we've seen so far. I really wasn't expecting so much of a fight out of Rob Van Dam. But obviously, he didn't beat Ezekiel Jackson. I guess it makes sense that he'd be the one that could bring the pain to him. But for the first time since his inception, that title has been retained. Ezekiel Jackson has done exactly what he set himself out to do, which is be one of the biggest and best people that could come in his direction and keep a hold of the championship.
Teams who have the best continuity are the most successful. Takes him down in a major way, too. Oh boy, he is great. And look at the quickness by Prelo. Yeah, no question. He's showing great energy as usual.
It's a tough spot to find yourself in, that's for sure.
But if anybody could break free from this, it's this superstar right here. Oh boy, he is real. Not today. Beautiful technique. What a stomp. Cool.
This is truly a test here to see what Carl Anderson can do. He has to come up with a plan quickly.
He may very well reach the point of return here with a six-man tag team.
I'm not used to seeing this.
Carl Anderson is feeling so hot right now.
Shoulder up. Gallo stays in this.
second time they're putting on a show. The crowd is eating it up.
This is not the first time flying group.
Look at this. Perhaps they can hope to do next year. Well, they're not too old, bro. And it's Epicard showing some agility. When these guys are on, look at it. And it's a reversal.
Thank you. understand how Gabriel has been successful. He has, but he's no disrespect to the artist. I'm hoping for having paid him so much for
Hey, you just took a Thank you. Ready to be a millionaire. I'm a millionaire. I'm a millionaire.